He said, how do I therefore take a prospect from their initial interest in me through to them coming on board with me without being salesy, yet being in control? I don't get how the two coexist. I said, okay, we have to climb a lot of steps. The very, very first step, which forms the foundation for everything else, is shared values. And the only shared value that you principally need to be concerned about is taking a genuine interest and concern in that business's outlook, aspirations, future, and current position. Because you've done that, you will start to establish rapport. Because you establish rapport, you'll feel comfortable in sharing how you've been through these similar situations, or your clients have, or both. This will resonate. You will build resonance and rapport. At the time of building resonance rapport, people like me, Alex, the client, feel far more inclined to talk to you about the big issues I've got. As a result of that, we get a conceptual agreement. We have a project and purpose agreed in principle of how we could work together. You then take it a stage further and you write me not a weak proposal, you write me the proposal that reflects what we talked about, that resonance and rapport. It has the same warmth in the printed word as it had when we were talking. I feel like you're here. Hopefully, unexpectedly, I then accept that proposal. From there, you deliver on your promises and you show that you have got tremendous value to offer, which was never really in doubt, but now we're seeing the benefit of it. Outcomes are created, therefore, and I have the down payment of my house move, or I have the reinvestment in capital equipment in my business. And at that point, Alex, we revert to step two and we continue to build that resonance and rapport. He says, so I can cross-sell to them. I said, no, because that's what you do. That's the right thing to do regardless. But it doesn't hurt if you do want to then add additional services onto them.